Blessed morning. Blessed morning. As you come on in, hit the tag and share button. Tag someone, hit the like button, share it. It's a fresh manna Monday. Glory to God. Glory to God. Blessed morning, blessed morning. Blessed morning, Johanna. Thank you for joining. Blessed morning, Pastor. Thank you for joining. As you come in, hit the like and share button. Tag someone. I know that you may be at work this morning. Today is the day that the Lord has made, and we're going to rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. Amen. Because we serve an amazing God. He's an unchanging God. And He loves us all the same. He is an amazing God. Amen. I'm going to wait for some more people to jump on this morning before I begin to release what the Lord has given us this morning. Amen. Amen. Blessed morning, Auntie Shelley. God bless you. I love you. The Lord knows each and one of us by name. Amen. Amen. I'm just so full of joy this morning. And this is how we should be every morning. Amen. We should, when we wake up, we give thanks to the Lord. You know, we enter His gates with thanksgiving and His outer courts with praise, giving Him all that to do His name. Because He is worthy of our praise. Amen. Just begin to praise the Lord right where you are. Give Him a shout, knowing that He will do just what He said He would do. And just because of who He is our Father. He is Abba the Father. Amen. So we thank the Lord this morning. We bless His holy name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Blessed morning, daughter. Blessed morning. Thank you for joining. Yes, God, we thank you this morning, Lord. We thank you this morning. Yes, it is a fresh manna Monday. I pray that everyone had a great weekend. Blessed morning, Sister Shirley. Thank you for joining. Thank you for joining. God bless you, woman of God. We thank the Lord this morning. Blessed morning. Blessed morning, Sister Carla. Thank you for joining. As you come on, please tag and share. Tag and share. Tag and share. We really don't worry about too many likes. But we just want to tag and share because we just want to share the goodness of the Lord. We want to make sure His word goes out, what He is about to release, because it's going to be a blessing to someone that needs to hear it. Amen. I just thank the Lord for what he is doing in this season, in spite of what has transpired around us and that what continues to transpire. We know the Lord is faithful, because he who has begun a great work in each and every one of you, he is faithful to complete it until the coming of Christ. Amen. We thank the Lord this morning. We thank the Lord this morning. We thank the Lord this morning. We have to set the tone. We have to set the atmosphere. So right where you are, just begin to worship. If you can't worship out loud, worship on the inside, thanking the Lord for all that he has done for you and all that he is about to do. Because I just feel a stirring in my spirit this morning. God bless you, Sister Wendy. Thank you for joining. Please share and tag someone that needs to hear a word from the Lord this morning. Glory to God. 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 Yes, in spite of all of our shortcomings, the Lord loves us unconditionally. It is important that we know how much the Lord loves us, because we can listen to people all day, every day, but we need to know that he loves us. We need to build a relationship, a personal relationship with the Lord. Seek his face so that he may fill us. Amen. We decrease so that the Lord may increase on the inside of us. We die to the flesh. We die to everything that is around us that is not of God. We put God first. We will see things manifest in our lives. And he requires intimacy with us. He desires to have it. As we desire to have things, so does the Lord. He wants to be with us. He wants to have our attention. Amen. I just thank the Lord for each and every one of you that are coming on this morning. Yes, we have to call on the name of Jesus, because that is the only name that will save us. Amen. No other name will do. Oh, no one can do what Jesus can do. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. I won't try to be long this morning, but we know when the Lord is moving, we have no control. Glory to God. Glory to God. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to begin. So this morning, our text is going to come from Jeremiah 33:6. And it says, "Behold, I will bring to it health and healing, and I will heal them, and I will reveal to them an abundance of peace and truth. Behold, I will bring to it health and healing, and I will heal them, and I will reveal to them an abundance of peace and truth." That is Jeremiah 33, chapter 33, verse 6. The Lord is getting ready to do a new thing. I just feel it in my spirit. Pastor Hall and I were discussing this the other day, and the Lord is getting ready to do a new thing. And we are in the stage of preparation. We have to remain in a posture where the Lord can shift us where he needs us to be when we keep our minds in posture and when we remain in position that the Lord can shift us. Amen. Because we don't want to do anything that will cause us to miss the shifting that God is getting ready to do in our lives. Amen. And as I was reading William Murphy's Praying Through It book, and the words just jumped out at me, and I pray that this message is helping someone this morning. And it just simply says, no more. No more. That's the title. And it says, no more sickness and disease. No more weariness and depression. No more bad dieting and overeating. No more anger issues and temper tantrums. No more unnecessary debt or overspending or being without money. No more. It ends today. And I declare I'll never be sick. Declare over your lives today, people of God, that you will never be sick another day in your life. You'll never be broke another day in your life. You'll never be without options another day in your life. You'll never be without anything, because you'll never be without Jesus. Amen. Another day in your life. Look, during this time, we need to make our election sure that we're going to be followers of Christ Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Because when we have Jesus, we have everything. Amen. Because the Lord says in Matthew 6:33, that when we seek ye first the kingdom of God and all his righteousness, everything else will be added unto us. Amen. We got to stay woke. But we decree and we declare today that there will be no more lack in our lives. There will be no more sickness and disease in our lives, because we speak healing over our lives. Amen. We speak health over our lives. We speak prosperity over our lives this morning. Amen. We got to set the tone, people of God. We have to speak that thing. We have to speak it. That way it can manifest. We have to pull on heaven this morning. Amen. The other day when I was sitting in my bed, and I was getting ready to go online for church service, and the Lord just ministered to me, and I began to hear, open heaven. Open heaven. We're under an open heaven, people of God. The Lord is getting ready to do something so mighty that we must remain in posture, that way we don't miss it. Amen. It's time that we start reaching up to heaven and pulling down what the Lord has for us. Knowing who we are in Christ Jesus. Knowing that our Father has everything that we need according to his riches and glory. He will supply all of our needs. Amen. So I thank the Lord this morning. I am so grateful. I'm just honored to be amongst the people of God, to be amongst the living this morning. Amen. Because many did not make it. We pray for those who are going through, who are the sick and the shut in this morning. We pray that the Lord sends his ministering angels to their bedsides right where they are. And we decree and declare healing over their bodies. They shall live and not die, but to declare the works of the Lord. Amen. For the Lord says there's greater works that we shall do. Amen. There are mighty exploits that the Lord is giving us to do in this land. The Lord is preparing us. The Lord is preparing us. He has to prepare us. We have to be in the place of preparation, and we thank you. We thank the Lord this morning. And I just want to share a bit of a dream that I had, and the Lord dropped in me this morning to go to particular scripture that I'm going to read also. But I'm not going to go into details of all the dreams, but the Lord gave me many visions and dreams last night. Glory to God. I'm just honored and grateful. But this particular part is the part that I'm led to release. Amen. So I was in the downtown area, and I saw my sister, and there was like this like crowd of people. And there was lines. I wasn't sure what the lines were for, but then I was with one of my coworkers, and we were just walking like we would normally walk on a lunch break or something, you know. So, and then I saw one of my aunts and my cousins, and then there were these bikes, those bikes that you know, pay to rent. There were bikes, and they were lined up, but there was one particular bike that I know that it was like a courtesy bike. So if you didn't have money, you can just jump on this bike and just ride it where you needed to go. And for some odd reason, that particular bike was sitting on a rack that it shouldn't have been on. Amen. Glory to God. Yes, God, I feel the Holy Spirit this morning. I thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. So that particular bike was on a rack that it wasn't supposed to be on. So all of a sudden, there was a rush of wind came. And I was like, Lord, I just need that bike. I need to get somewhere. And I don't believe I had either the right amount of change that needed to be put in the machine. But then I kept saying to myself, no, this bike is free. I shouldn't pay for something that I don't have to pay for. Amen. So I was like, Lord, I need that bike. And after the wind began to pick up, the bike fell over off of the rack that it was on. Glory to God. Glory to God. The bike fell off the rack. Glory to God. I was able to get on the bike and get to where I needed to go because it was getting dark. It was actually getting dark as well. So I got on the bike and I began to ride. And as I began to ride on the bike, my aunt said, wow. And I said, there's nothing to be wild about, because when you walk in faith, and when you walk in faith and you know who your Father is, and you know what He possessed, and you know the power that is on the inside of you, I remember these words verbatim in my dream. I told her, remember, whatever you need, God will supply it. Whatever you want, God will give you the desire of it. Whatever it is, God will blow on it, amen, to make it fall right in your hands. You just got to be there to catch it. You just got to be there to receive it, amen. You got to be at the right place at the right time. You got to remain in your position. That way you can receive what God has given you, amen. So we thank the Lord this morning for blowing on us. Just say, blow on me, Lord. Blow on me. Blow on it. Whatever it is that you need for God to do in your lives this morning, ask the Lord to blow on it. When I tell you that helped me, that just took me. I was like, Lord, whatever it is that I need you to blow on me. Amen. I thank the Lord this morning for that. And the Lord told me to go to Acts 2, chapter 2. And it's talking about filling with the Holy Ghost. And I'm going to read from the first verse to the fourth verse. And it says, and when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. And they and there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of fire, and it set upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. Glory to God. When I tell you that in this season, in this, when you are in your position and you remain in your posture, the Lord is getting ready to come and do something. When we are all on one accord, when you are on one accord with God, there's going to be something suddenly happen. Say suddenly. The Lord is getting ready to do something suddenly. This just this blessed me this morning when the Lord revealed this to me. The Lord is getting ready to do something suddenly, and I know this is a familiar scripture, and I know we've heard it over and over and over again, but the Lord is getting ready to do something suddenly. And it may, someone who's on this live may not be, it may not be familiar to you. That's why I encourage you to share and tag someone, because someone may not know what this scripture is talking about. But I hear the Lord is getting ready to do something suddenly, and as in my dream, he came with a mighty rushing wind and he made that bike fall off the rack. And I'm telling you, the Lord is getting ready to blow somebody's mind. He's getting ready to pull some things off the racks that was held up, some things that was held up on racks that you couldn't get to. Lord is about to release it in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord, this morning. I glorify you, Lord. We thank you this morning, Lord God, for filling us. We thank you for your Holy Spirit, Lord. And the day of Pentecost. So, Aka, my mind, soul, I decree and declare by the day of Pentecost of May next year, the month of May, the Lord is getting ready to do something mightily. He's getting ready to blow somebody's mind. And I guarantee you that you're going to be like, wow. Just remember, when the Lord does just what he says he's going to do, he's not a man that he should lie, and not a son of man that he should repent. His word will not return back unto him void. Amen. So we stand and on the word of God this morning. Oh, my God. Because, yes, it is harvest time. Yes, those seeds that have been planted, those things that have just been held up, are getting ready to be released. But we have to remain in posture and in position to receive what the Father has for us. Amen. I just thank the Lord this morning for what he's doing. I pray that this word this morning, this fresh manna from heaven, is getting, it's filling you up this morning. It's giving you a new intake. We just thank the Lord this morning. We thank him for the bread of heaven. Glory to God. Glory to God. And if the wind, the rushing wind, fill all the house, the Lord is getting ready to fill your houses. The Lord is getting ready to do some things. Yes, God. I thank you, Lord God, for the breaking of chains, for the pulling down of strongholds, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for the release. We thank you, Lord God, for there will be no more lack in the name of Jesus. We thank you this morning, Father. Someone needs to be filled with the Holy Spirit. Yes, God. You feel because you don't speak in tongues that the Lord doesn't hear your prayers, or the Lord is not answering your prayers. That is not so. The Lord says, when you desire a thing, ask him. It's a gift from God. It is a gift from God. But more importantly, make sure that you are right on the inside. So when you receive what the Lord has for you, you will work and you will allow the Holy Spirit to work on the inside of you. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. I pray that this message is blessing you this morning. If you have a great God, you will have a little devil. But if you have a big devil, you will have a little God. I spoke this on the Saturday morning prayer meeting line. We got to put God first in all that we do. We have to continuously make God the head. He is the Godhead. We got to make sure that he is head over our lives. Amen. We got to give him the time that he desires of us. I just thank the Lord this morning. And, you know, it's without question. When we are followers of Christ, you know, that sometimes we greatly missed after his ascension from the cross to heaven. But the Holy Spirit was everything that the Lord had promised he would be. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. That's why we cannot miss the mark, people. We cannot miss the mark. We cannot miss the mark. We have to stay focused. We got to keep moving and moving forward. We got to keep moving forward. Don't look back. Don't worry about yesterday. Don't worry about the former days, because the latter days will be great. God is getting ready to do a new thing. God is getting ready to do a new thing. There are some things getting ready to manifest in your lives that you've been waiting on God to do. There's getting ready to be a great feast. Oh, there's going to be a great feast. The Lord says, when you are grateful for the few, he will make you the ruler over much. I'm just paraphrasing this morning. Glory to God. I just feel a sense of release. My spirit is at ease with the word of God. And in spite of what is going on around us, the Lord still is blessing his people. He is still blessing his people. A lot of people are missing what God is doing because they're too focused on other things that don't even matter. They matter in the natural, but they don't matter in the supernatural, because all things, God can do all things. All things work together for the good. All things work together for the good. But when we put our focus on who is important, God should be the main attraction. Not man, not money, but God. Because he supplies all those things. It all belongs to him. Everything that we need belongs to God. We just have to do our part. We have to pray, seek his face, turn from our evil, wicked ways. Then he will hear from heaven and he will heal our land. We have to pray for one another. We have to lift each other up. Iron sharpens iron. We're here to encourage. I pray this morning that you are all blessed. You are blessed. You are blessed. You are blessed. You woke up this morning. You're blessed. You're blessed. We may not have everything that we want, but we surely have everything that the Lord, that we need in this time. And the Lord is going to give us more of what we need. Amen. Those businesses, those books, the Lord is getting ready to expand your territory. He's getting ready to stretch you, but you got to be prepared for the stretching. So it's like when you get ready to go to the gym and you want to get a good workout in, you need to stretch before you work out. Stretch, loosen up your muscles. Because God is about to flex on us. He's about to flex his muscles. He's about to show us exactly who he is. And he's already showing us. We just been focused on too many other things. Amen. I encourage you, because during this time, the Lord is putting our faith in work. We have to focus on those things. And when we focus on the things of God, knowing that he's going to fulfill every promise that he said he would fulfill. His promises are yes and amen. I just thank the Lord this morning. Isaac sold in the famine, and he reaped 100-fold. He dug well after well. And was able to reap. Yeah, we put a prayer in there this morning. The Lord will enlarge your territory. It's going to expand you. The well that was named Rehoboth, the Lord is making room. He's making room for what's about to come. Yes, Sister Carla, we thank the Lord for you for joining this morning. We speak healing over your life this morning. We speak healing over your life this morning. Give glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We just magnify the Lord this morning. So, I pray that this has blessed you in the name of Jesus. Amen. Glory. I'm just excited about what God is about to do. There's so many different things that are taking place, and the Lord is just moving mightily. And we just gotta remain in posture, remain in position. That way we can receive, and we gotta continuously speak those things that are not as though they were. Faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. So we thank the Lord this morning. So we're going to pray this morning, and then we're going to be released and to continue out your wonderful days. Heavenly Father, Lord God, we just thank you this morning. Thank you for the wonderful people that have joined on this live this morning, Father God. Lord God, I pray that this life has been a blessing to them, Lord God. Lord God, I pray that every desire, every need that they have will be met in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord God, I ask that you go before them, Father God. You make all crooked places straight, all rubber surfaces smooth, Father God. Lord God, you shield them with your shield of protection, Father God, as they go in and as they come out, Lord God. Lord God, we thank you, Father God, that you are a fence around us, Lord God. that you keep us, Lord God, from dangers seen and unseen, Father God. And Lord God, we thank you for the prosperity. We thank you for the mighty rushing wind, Father God, that you're about to blow on us and is about to bless us, Lord God, and blow our minds in this next move that you have for us, Lord. So we thank the Lord this morning that there will be no more lack. There will be no more not meeting your needs this morning. There will be prosperity in your lives. No more looking back, remembering the old things, for the old things have passed away. Behold, all things become new. You are a new creature in Christ Jesus. The old man has died. Amen. Behold, all things are new, because we serve a living God. So we have to be in a living position. Amen. So I thank the Lord this morning. May he continue to shine his face upon you and be with you. And I pray that you all have a wonderful week. Be blessed, and we love you all. Talk to you soon.